imagine you're in a world where electrons are colored, and there are only two colors, red and blue. So think of them as red and blue cars, and your roads are also colored red and blue. So if you're a red car, you drive on the red roads, and you follow the direction of the red roads. Okay. So now if you're a blue car, and you follow the direction of the blue road. So now imagine if you're a blue car driving happily along a northbound road, and you come to a four-way junction. And you look over on the other side, you notice that the northbound road is now colored red, and the southbound road is now colored blue. So you are a blue car, you want to go north, but the northbound road is only for red cars. So if you can't change your color, you cannot go, right? So that's essentially the way that we have created this traffic control at a four-way junction. This red and blue color that I'm using for the electrons are their valley indices. The roads are specially designed so that each color goes in a particular direction. That is the topology aspect of the system over here. So what we have done is we have changed the way the roads are colored on different sides of the junction, and that's changing the topology of the system. So by doing so, we can control the flow of traffic. So it works like a valve, and that's what we call a topological valley valve because the way it's working. So now, if you're a blue car and you can't go forward, what would you do? So there's two options. You can turn right or you can turn left. So it turns out that we have additional controls that let us choose whether an electron is most likely turning left or right by just basically nudging the roads closer to the left turn or to the right turn. So in technical terms, that's called a beam splitter. And what we have done is made an electron beam splitter for electrons, which are cars in this case.